Let's talk a little bit more about the importance of mother-child emotional bonding and how it is related to food. Most of you have probably heard about postpartum depression, a condition where mothers cannot take care of their babies for several days, sometimes weeks and even months. This can create abandonment trauma in a child's psyche. The first emotional contact is a reciprocal smile which happens between the first and second month of a baby's life. If the mother shows her emotional connection with the baby, then the child develops a sense of love and security. Love and security are two most important things for every baby to experience in order for him to create a healthy psyche. The first conscious anxiety of the absence of the mother develops around at the age of 7 months, and conscious fear of strangers develops at 8 months. This is another important period when mother should be very careful when she leaves her baby with a nanny, grandparents, or at a preschool. This should be a process of gradual and safe separation. A baby must learn that his mom is always coming back. The mother should start with a small windows of separation and gradually increase it. On average, 7 to 9 months old babies are extremely sensitive to the development of any type of anxiety, stress, and fear. At this age, we form three important beliefs that will impact the rest of our lives. 1. The world is a safe place to live, or the world is a dangerous place to live. 2. I can trust people, or I cannot trust people because they might abandon me. 3. The world is an abundant place, or the world has limited resources. If a baby had a limited amount of emotional contact with his mother during the first year of his life, then there is a high chance that this child will develop a trust issue growing up. This child might, 1. Struggle with making good friends at school. 2. Get involved with a bad crowd during their teenage years. 3. End up in a toxic romantic relationship. 4. Have a hard time creating committed relationships in the future. 5. Have issues with colleagues at work and problems with working in a team. 6. Develop a good girl, good boy syndrome, also known as a savior syndrome. 7. Develop an overeating problem. There are just few possible scenarios. Let's talk more about how people develop a neural personality type. Sigmund Freud was the first to introduce the concept of the oral stage of child development into the world of psychology. He used the word fixation to explain what happens with the psyche when a child has problems in this stage. A child might develop an oral fixation when he does not receive enough milk. This could occur in a few different scenarios. 1. A child has a problem sucking the nipple. 2. A mother does not generate enough milk. 3. A mother does not hold her baby while feeding. She gives him a bottle and the baby does not create an emotional connection with her. 4. A baby has to be tube fed because he was born immature or has other medical problems. All these factors might create a neural fixation and cause a child to develop a neural personality. People with a neural personality can be divided into two main groups. First one, those who develop a passive dependency, and the second group are those who develop an aggressive dependency. When a child does not receive enough milk or the mother does not feed him on time, a child might lay down quietly waiting for his mother. He might cry a bit, but most of the time he will be passive, waiting for his mother. This child will develop a passive dependency. An opposite reaction, when a child cries loudly and excessively, he demands his mother's attention. This is his way of asking to be fed. This child will bite his mother's breast if there is not enough milk. This child will likely develop an aggressive type of dependency. The way a child communicates with the mother is the foundation of how he will communicate with other people when he grows up. So let's talk more about passive and aggressive dependency. Examples of passive dependency in adulthood: smoking or an alcohol addiction. A person protects quietly, suppressing his emotions with alcohol or with cigarettes. Eating problems. A person overeats or does not eat enough food. Again, this is a passive protest. A person does not express his emotions. He's suppressing them with food. Please watch my two other free webinars that are already on YouTube. One, Food as a Substitute for Love, and two, Emotional Eating. Tell me what you eat and I will tell you what problems you have. The third example of passive dependency is love addiction. This refers to people who end up in toxic relationships, dependent relationships, relationships with a narcissistic person, long-distance relationship, or a situation of unrequited or one-sided love. Often a person struggles in the relationship but is afraid to leave their partner. This person hopes that one day their partner will change and love them the way they feel they deserve. This person is afraid to be single. Remember, we spoke about the abandonment trauma with the mother. This person subconsciously is afraid to leave this type of toxic relationships because the pain from his childhood is hidden so deep inside of him and his psyche does not want to face it again. The person will stay in those toxic relationships until they experience a bigger pain than their fear of abandonment. Many times a person might hit rock bottom before they realize that this time they have to leave. Please click the like button if you understand what I'm talking about. Please share your questions and your stories in the comments. I really appreciate when you share your thoughts under my videos. Please don't be afraid to open up. I'm here to help you on your self-development journey. If you don't write your comments, if you don't share your story, then it's not possible for me to support you. I release a new video 2-3 times a week. I do Q&A videos where I answer your questions. Please consider subscribing and clicking the notification bell so you won't miss any future free self-development webinars and educational videos. Let's continue talking about the oral fixation and discuss the second type of dependency, which is aggressive dependency. Examples of aggressive dependency. When a child is sucking his mother's nipple and not getting enough milk, he becomes hungry and aggressive. The child has to use a physical force in order to receive food. Subconsciously, he develops an internal belief that he must be aggressive in order to achieve what he wants. He must be aggressive in order to get what he wants. He must be aggressive in order for other people to hear and to notice him. In order to reach his goal, he must use all of his power and might even be violent, or he might be left with nothing. He has to demand what he wants. He has to be in control of the situation. He has to create fights and arguments all the time. Examples of people with aggressive dependency: a person who creates fights over small things. A person who likes to argue and won't stop until other people agree with him. A person who likes aggressive sports like MMA and boxing. A person who likes sarcasm and offensive jokes. A person who likes to abuse others to meet his own ends. A person who creates an emotional roller coaster in relationships. This person likes drama and conflict. This type of person can joke saying there is nothing better than a sex after the big fight. And for them, it's true. Conflicts in romantic relationships can really spice up their sex life. Of course, some people can be more aggressive than others. It depends on the rules and traditions that a child was raised in. Aggressive and passive dependency can be also developed when the mother overfeeds the baby. When mother cannot understand if a baby is full or not. In this situation, we can also develop two types of reaction. One, a baby might continue eating even if he is already full, and that's why we eat more than we need. Two, a child might bite his mother's breast or throw food to show his protest. And this way, the child will develop an aggressive type of dependency, aggressive personality. Please watch my free webinars entitled Food as a Universal Remedy. In this webinar, I talk about how we get emotionally attached to food from the moment we're born through our childhood and teenage years into adult life. I share a lot of stories and examples in this webinar. Again, the name of the webinar is Food as a Universal Remedy for Better and for Worse. The link is below the video. Please watch it after this one.